Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson and what is the name of the lesson? Reproduction in animals. And in this point already, in this lesson already we have seen some points. We have discussed about the fertilization, we have discussed about the internal and external fertilization. So today we will move for the next point from the same lesson, that is today we will discuss about the male reproductive organs and also we will discuss about the female reproductive organs. So let's start with the first point, that is male reproductive organs. Okay, so the male reproductive organ mainly consists of three main parts, that are, we can say that two sperm ducts, also penis and a pair of testes. Okay, and the pair of testes, and singularly we can say as what? Testes. Okay, so these are the three main parts of the male reproductive system, or these are the three main reproductive organ of male. Okay, so what are the three main organs? We can say that were two pairs of sperm duct, two pair of testes, singularly testes, and one penis. These are the male reproductive organ. So in these testes, or singularly we can say that what, in the testes the sperms get produced. What do you mean by the sperms? Sperms means what? Male gametes, that we have already discussed in our previous video. Okay, so the production of the sperm is happens in the testes, and that sperms are very small. Okay, the sperms are very small. It is the single cell, but it also contains all the components of the cell, all usual components of the cell. Mainly the sperms are having three parts, that are head, middle piece and tail. Okay, so this is the diagram of human sperm, and this human sperm is the smallest cell in the human body. It is the single cell which is also having all the usual components like a other cell. So what are the parts of the human cell? Human sperms basically having the three parts, that are, this here you can see that is what? Head. Next one part here you can see, that is what? Middle piece. And the last one you can see, that is what? Tail. So with the help of this tail, these sperms can easily do the locomotion in the body of human. Okay, so this is about what? Male reproductive organ in human. Now we will discuss about the female reproductive organ in humans. So the female reproductive system, or the female reproductive organs, are oviduct, which is also called as what? Fallopian tube. Next one is what? Ovary. And the third one is what? Uterus. Okay, so the male female reproductive organs, or the female reproductive system, consists the three basic part, or three main part, that are oviduct, or also it is called as what? Fallopian tube. Next one is what? Ovary. So like that, there are the two ovaries are there, so we can say that ovaries. And the next one is what? Uterus. So all these are the female reproductive organ present in the humans. Okay, so in the male we have seen that the testes produce the male gamete, which is called as what? Sperms. Like that, in the female also the gametes get produced inside the ovary. Okay, so which is the female gamete? That is nothing but what? Egg or ova. Okay, eggs or the ova, these are what? This is the name of the female gamete, and this female gamete is get produced into the ovary. So in this way, what we can say, that single mature egg is get released into the oviduct by one of the ovary every month. And uterus is the place where the new individual get developed. Okay, so in the uterus the development of the new baby is happens. Or in this way, these are the parts of the female reproductive system, or also we can say that what, these are the organs of female reproductive system. Like a sperm, sperm is a single cell. like that these human ovum is also the single cell, but it is quite bigger than the sperm. Okay, so the human ovum is bigger than the sperm, and it is also a single cell which is also contain all the basic or all the usual components of the cell. So here is the diagram of the human ovum. You can see here is a nucleus, there is a cytoplasm, cell membrane is also there, and in this way all the usually whatever the components are present in the basic components of the cell are present, and all the components are present in the human ovum. Okay, so in this way these are the male and the female reproductive organs. What are the female reproductive organ? Two sperm ducts, pair of testes and penis. These are the organs of male reproductive system. Also we can say that the pair of the testes produces the male gamete, which is called as what? Sperm. While which are the female reproductive organs? Oviduct, ovary and the uterus. These are the three female reproductive organ. And which is the female gamete? The female gamete is called as what? Egg or ova. And also we can call as what? Ovum. Singularly we can call as what? Ovum. Okay, this way the female gamete get produced into the ovary, and here is the structure of the human ovum. Okay, so this is all about what? Male and female reproductive organ. So in our previous video we have already discussed about the fertilization. What is mean by the fertilization? The fusion of the male and the female gamete is called as what? Fertilization. We have seen the different types of the fertilization. Also we have seen about the internal fertilization and the external fertilization. What is meant by internal fertilization? Internal fertilization happens in the female's body, while external means what? Outside. What is mean by the external fertilization? External fertilization means what? The fertilization which happens outside the female's body. This is generally happens in the fish and the eggs. Okay, so here I want to tell you some other things about the external fertilization. In the external fertilization, the females are laying the eggs in a number. Okay, or there the females are laying the eggs in the thousands or in a hundred numbers. Why is it so? Because the fertilization is happens externally with the help of the water. Okay, so the every time the fertilization will happens, we cannot say that. Okay, once the eggs are laid by the female, then what happens? The male releases a thousands of the sperms into the water. But why they are laying the eggs in the thousand number, and why they are leaving the sperms in the thousands number? Though the females are giving the eggs in a thousand number and the males are releasing the sperms in the thousand number, all the eggs do not get fertilized and get converted into the new individual. Why is it so? This is because the eggs get exposed to the different factors, the factors like water, rainfall and also the wind. Also these eggs are the food for the other animals, those who are living in the water. That is the reason the production of the thousands of the eggs and the sperm is necessary for ensure the fertilization of at least few of the eggs. Okay, so see, they are giving the eggs in a large number, but it doesn't mean that all the eggs will get fertilized, because there are the certain reasons, and because of that reasons the all the eggs will not get fertilized. Among that eggs, only the few eggs are getting fertilized. Okay, so this is all about today we have discussed about the male and the female reproductive organs, and also we have discussed about the external fertilization. So here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and today's your homework is that you have to draw all these diagrams in your biology notebook. Here we will stop. I will tell you goodbye. We'll meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.